now we are going to solve the second problem. So this is the block diagram. So we are going to reduce this block diagram by step-by-step process, right? So first, considering the block diagram, first we have to give reference to the series block. After that, we have to give reference to the parallel block, and then we have to give preference to the feedback path, right? So first we can see whether in this block diagram, whether we have the series block or parallel block. Or first, what we have to make the system to be reduced, right? So first we can see this block diagram. Here we have two blocks, one is G2 and G3 or series, but in between these two blocks we have a branch point. So we can't apply the first rule, that is cascading the two blocks, right? So next we have to see what modification we can do means. So here we have one forward path gain, right? So this is nothing but if this forward path gain is connected to a summing point, means this type of block or this type of system is called as parallel block. So we can reduce this parallel block, but in between this parallel block we have a branch point. So we can't apply here. So what we can do means, first we can move this branch point before the block. The first thing is to make these two blocks as cascade. So we have to move this branch point before the block. So what is the condition to change the branch point before the block means, we have to multiply or we have to multiply with this gain, right? So I'm just in step one moving branch point before the block. So if you are moving this branch point towards here, so you can see here, so I am moving G3 block towards in front of G2. So just in this line I am just multiplying with the gain of this G2 value. So I have to come like this. So we have to redraw this block diagram like this. So now we have to see, so what are the rules we can apply in this block diagram. So if you are seeing this side, so here we have two blocks are connected in cascade. So if two blocks are connected in cascade means we can multiply that two signals, right? So I am just multiplying these two signals, that is G2 into G3. So we can eliminate two individual blocks into a single block, right? Next, if you are seeing this, here we have a branch point is connected to this gain. This is nothing but a forward path, right? So this forward path is connected to the summing point. So here we have the summing point. This input, this line is this arrow pointing towards the positive polarity, and again this line is pointing towards the positive polarity. So this is nothing but parallel connection. So we can eliminate this by using the root 2, that is combining the parallel block. So we can write this as, so both are connected to plus, so this block plus this value. So we can replace this as G2 G3 plus G4. So we can replace like this. So now, so again, here these two blocks are cascaded, that is H1 into G2. So next step, what we can do means to reduce this block diagram. So we have to move the summing point, right? So here we have branch point and here we have summing point. So when compared to branch point and summing point, first preference we should give to summing point. That will be easy to reduce the block diagram. So I am moving the summing point before the block, right? So what is the rule? Moving the summing point before the block means we have to take the reciprocal of this gain, right? So in step 4, in first step, we have cascaded, or we moved the branch point. After that, we have combined the cascaded blocks. In step 3, we have we have combined the parallel blocks, right? So next, in the fourth step, we are going to move the summing point before the block. So here we are moving the summing point towards, that is before the G1. So I am moving the summing point towards here. So we will have this value 1 by G1. So in this point we will be multiplying with 1 by G1. So now, so after this, what we can do means we can interchange these two summing points. We can interchange the summing point. So interchanging your summing point will be very easy, right? So interchanging a summing point, in the sense, just I am redrawing this summing point here and replacing this summing point towards here. So the summing point have the same polarity, just we have to remove this connections, right? So I am just making this I am redrawing this, then it will be very easy for you to understand. So step 5, interchanging the summing point. Interchanging the summing point. So first here we have summing point. Again here we have the summing point. Again here we have the summing point. Next we have our G1, then we have G2, G3 plus G4. Here our output. Okay, now just I am replacing this summing point towards here. So in this summing point I have the connection of 1 by G1 with H2, and this H2 is connected to this output line, right? Now this summing point is, I am redrawing this here. So here we have, so here we have H1, G2. This H1, G2 is connected to before G1. So again here we have another summing, it is connected to here, right? So I am just interchanging the summing point, we will get a block diagram like this. Now looking to this block diagram, here these two blocks are series block. So we can combine the series blocks. So we will we can replace this into H2 divided by G1. We can replace this block into H2 divided by G1, right? So again we can replace this, right? So this is nothing but a feedback, that is output is fed back to the input, feedback, right? So if the feedback is connected to the negative polarity, so if this output is fed back to the input, this point is, this feedback signal is pointing towards the negative polarity, means that type of feedback is called as negative feedback. So how we can reduce the negative feedback, means by using the formula G divided by 1 plus GH. So here the value of G is equal to G1, and here the value of H is equal to H1, G2. So substituting this in this formula, we will get the, we can replace this block as, we can replace the next step 6 is, so after completing the step 5, we have to go for step 6. Step 6 is eliminating the feedback loop. So here we have negative feedback, so we can eliminate. So the formula is, to eliminate the negative feedback, the formula is G divided by 1 plus GH. Here the value of G is G1 divided by 1 plus G1 into H1, G2. So here the feedback of H is, H signal is nothing but H1 into G2. So now we can replace this block with this value. So again, redrawing this block diagram, we will get, here we have summing point. Again, here we have another summing point. So this block is replaced with the value of G1 divided by 1 plus G1 G2 H1. Next we have G2 G3 G2 G3 plus G4. Here we have our output signal. So again this output signal is connected with right here in the summing point plus minus. Here we have the feedback signal as H2 divided by G1. And next we have R. It is connected with this. Right? So what is the next step? So next how we can reduce this block diagram. So here we have two blocks are in cascade, right? In series. So if two blocks are in series, we have to multiply each other. Right? So we will get the value as that is G1 divided by 1 plus G1 G2 H1 into G2 G3 plus G4. Right? So again multiplying these two terms we will get G1 G2 G3 plus G1 G4 divided by 1 plus G1 G2 H1. So we can replace these two blocks. Now we can replace these two blocks into a single block. Now we can replace these two blocks into a single block as G1, G2, G3 plus G1, G4 the whole divided by 1 plus G1, G2. Here we have H1, right? So H1. So now we can reduce, again we can reduce this block diagram. So how we can reduce this block diagram means this is nothing but a feedback, right? Feedback loop. So here this feedback path is connected with negative polarity. Same way the formula is G divided by 1 plus GK. So the value of G is equal to this and the value of H will be is equal to H2 divided by 1. So by substituting this value in the negative feedback equation, we will get G1, G2, G3 plus G1, G4 divided by, that is the value of G, G1, G2, H1, the whole divided by 1 plus G1, G2, G3 plus G1, G4 divided by 1 plus G1, G2, H1 into the value is H2 divided by G1. Right? So again simplify this expression. For taking LCM we will get or in this term we can in both the term we have G1 G1 so take it outside so we will get this G1 G1 get cancelled right so again taking LCM on this equation we will get G1 G2 G3 plus G1 G4 divided by 1 plus G2 G1 H1 the whole divided by 1 plus taking LCM on this term G1 G2 H1 plus G2 G3 H2 multiplied with this value plus G4 H2 whole divided by 1 plus G2 G1 H1. So these two terms will cancel. So we will get the value as G1 G2 G3 plus G1 G4 G4 divided by 1 plus G1 G2 H1 plus G2 G3 H2 plus G4 H2. So we can replace this block as this value. Right? Again, from this expression, you will get here we have the summing point, here we have the signal arc, and here we have this answer to the this value. So if the signal is connected like this, if it is connected like this, so we have to take this as a closed loop with unity feedback gain. The closed loop path with a unity feedback gain. So here the gain of H of a feedback path, the gain of feedback path is nothing but 1. Right? So if the line is connected from output towards the input, so this gain of this line, the gain of this path is equal to 1. Right? So now we have to replace this. So here also, here this feedback is connected to negative symbol. So this is nothing but a negative feedback. So the formula is G divided by 1 plus GH. So here the value of G is this and the value of H will be equal to 1. So now substituting this value and replacing this. So by reducing that feedback path, we will get the equation, final equation is that is, we can reduce the whole block diagram into and find out the transfer function as C by R is equal to G1, G2, G3 plus G1, G4 the whole divided by 1 plus G1, G2, H1 plus G2, G3, H2 plus G4, H2 plus G1, G2, G3 plus G1, G4. Thank you, students.